Oh boy, we're back on the weekly grind. Welcome to MCW Raw, episode 11. This is the fallout from MCW WrestleMania. I am the Warrior Chambers alongside Damian Wrestling Figs. And tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we have a stacked card for you. But let's talk about WrestleMania for a moment. The main event, the triple threat match for the war title, an absolute banger, and I recommend you guys check it out if you haven't already. But as a result, Ghost was the new champion. But let's start this one off here tonight. And there's no other way to start off MCW Raw than with the MCW Hardcore Champion, Joseph Laymon. The following opening contest is scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Chicago, Illinois, weighing in at 219 pounds, the MCW Hardcore Champion, Joseph Laymon. And Joseph Laymon retained his MCW Hardcore Championship last week on the pre-show of WrestleMania. Too bad it wasn't televised, but I'm telling you that from experience. That match was chaotic. Joseph literally did a Pepsi plunge through a table to Kano, but he defeated Kano Attack and stayed MCW Hardcore Champion, and that shows that he is a fighting MCW Hardcore Champion. He is one of the longest reigning MCW Hardcore Champions in history. He's about to conquer Kane's reign, but let's see if he can prove his skill in this non-title match against EDF. Joseph handed his title off to the referee. He is ready for this matchup, but you gotta wonder what kind of condition is he in after that hardcore match with Kano last week. And here comes the psychopath, who also won his match at MCW WrestleMania by spearing Kayden collects through a freaking flaming table, EDF. Corbin put up a good showing at WrestleMania last week as well, spearing, as I said earlier, spearing Kayden collects through that flaming table, hitting the disaster piece to win the matchup. And his opponent from Burns Flat, Oklahoma, weighing in at 249 pounds, the psychopath, EBF. Corbin making his way down to the ring, and if he could win this matchup, he could possibly get a hardcore championship title shot in the future because he beats the champion. But as I said just moments ago, if he wants to get a shot, meaning this is a non-title match, a non-title singles match to start off here tonight on Raw. And I gotta tell you, WrestleMania was a crazy show. I can't wait for this episode of Raw to continue the craziness for Mania. And what no other way to start off than these two men facing off one-on-one here tonight. Here we go to start off Raw, ladies and gentlemen, a non-title match. The Hardcore Champion, Joseph Laymon versus EBF. And as you see, a tested strength going to start off the match. But it looks like Joseph not having any offense in on that. And it looks like Joseph going to get out of it. And the roundhouse kick to the face of EBF, and now that armbar locked in Joseph, and oh my god, Joseph gonna lay in the elbows to the side of the head, gonna wear down Corbin. Now Joseph really getting the work in on Corbin's arm. If he can wear down Corbin, Corbin won't be able to do anything with those arms, and that's a main factor in the wrestling match, your arms and weight. Looks like Corbin's gonna get out of it. Corbin trying to break it up. He's back up on his feet, ladies and gentlemen. Gonna push Joseph off. Kick to the gut. What does he have in mind? The Impaler DDT, dropping Joseph on the top of his head. Joseph really getting dropped on his head, ladies and gentlemen. And now Corbin looking for a back suplex. Joseph flips out. And now going to run over to Corbin. And now looking for the Kenta Rush. The Kenta Rush combo, backhand, and then the roundhouse kick to finish up that combo. And it looks like Joseph has the upper hand again. And he's on the apron. What does he have in mind? And now looking to go to the high-risk district. Look out! No, spear! Spear! Corbin has done it again. The first time he has done that, it was with Figure Universe, and Joseph Laymon suffers the same fate here tonight. And now Corbin has him in position. He's looking to put the final nail in the coffin, and he's looking for the wait a minute. Why the hell is Kayden Collects coming out here? Kayden Collects, the man that Corbin speared through that flaming table last week, at WrestleMania to win the matchup, and he is coming out here to distract Corbin. The referee barely ejects him. And now Corbin and Collects talking trash to each other. I think Corbin wanted to get his head back inside the game, and now Collects saying he don't want no problems with him. And now turning back around, Joseph back up. And now Irish rip into the corner, knee strike. And now looking for the Bulldog. And Joseph has Corbin where he wants him, getting him back up. He's looking for it. He's looking to make Corbin go to sleep. No! Corbin caught the knee, getting him down on the mat. And now looking for it. Corbin's looking for the psychotic vice. He has it locked in, but Collects on the apron, distracting the referee. And now the psychotic vice is in, and look at the wrench on that thing. Look at the wrench, and Joseph is tapping, but the referee doesn't see it, so the match isn't ending. And now Corbin gonna swing and miss at Collects, because Collects jumps off the apron. Now Collects is gonna tell Corbin to turn around. And now a kick to the gut by Joseph, and now he has Corbin. What is he looking for? Oh, then welcome to Chicago, backbreaker. And mocking Corbin goes Collects, cringing in pain. And I think Corbin might be screwed for the rest of the match here. That backbreaker looked severe. And now getting back up, and he's turning around. Joseph getting him up on the shoulders again. Where he connected, he's looking for a GTS, and he does. Joseph just made Corbin go to sleep. 1, 2, 3. Here is your winner of this match, the MCW Hardcore Champion, Joseph Laymon. And Joseph was able to do it. He was able to beat Corbin here tonight, but at what cost? He didn't even know Kayden Collects was out here, but he probably was aware of it, but not fully aware of it. And as you see, Joseph on the top on that turnbuckle posing. But here's some highlights from this matchup, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to show the highlights of this match. As you see, Corbin hits that Impaler DDT, spiking Joseph on his head. And then this might have to be the craziest moment of the match, that spear. And there was a knee to the corner, or a knee to the face in the corner. And then the Welcome to Chicago backbreaker. And then to end the matchup right here, Corbin was hit with a little bit of some GTS. And that one ended Corbin in this one. But congratulations to Joseph.
The BK $5 Your Way meal is here to make your choice easy and so tasty. Go straight to the Double Whopper Jr. with piping hot small fries, four-piece crispy nuggets, and a refreshing small drink. Can you believe you get all this for only $5? The $5 Your Way meal, only at Burger King.
Are you tired of being old? Well, if you are, we have the perfect solution. DEW's cream. Make sure you squeeze it out nice and good. 2 squirts and rub that trap in. And one day later, you should be nice and young. Look at that. Didn't that work perfect, man?
If you have a history of heart problems, do not use this cream. It may cause death.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to MCW Raw, episode 11. We're about to hear from the new MCW International Champion, George the Hitman Quick. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the new MCW International Champion, George the Hitman Quick. As we know, last week at WrestleMania, George was able to defeat Jack to become the new MCW International Champion. And after the match, a surprise Kurt Angle came out, and I guess he wants a title shot against George in the near future, but George is out here tonight. What the hell's underneath that tarp, and why is there a trash can inside the ring? We're about to find out as George is calling in for a microphone. What does he have to say here tonight, ladies and gentlemen? I'm curious if it's about his victory at WrestleMania.
Hello, everybody.
Hey.
Y'all.
Y'all know who I am already, but fuck it.
I would like to reintroduce myself as your new international champion. Right here. But, you know, the more I look at this title on my shoulder here, I realize how ugly this piece of shit is. So, I want to change that. This title is below me. This title is a disgrace to me. So, I had another one made. And I will get that out right now.
And what the hell is George about to do with the international title? He just dumped in that trash can. That title is going, it just happened to be his 1 year anniversary on Sunday. And wait a minute. And what is this new? Oh my god, that's a nice looking title. I'm not even gonna lie. But why do you have to throw the other one in the trash can? What the hell?
And look at this thing. Look at this title. Look at how pretty it is, man. You know, you might be asking yourself though, George, why did you have this made? Because I knew I was going to win. I knew I was going to win the second I called him out. And, you know, I proved myself right. But, you know, after the disgrace that was Jack's title reign, I must take it upon myself to be a better champion. So, I would like to call out any one of the marks in the back to come out here and face me for this title.
And it looks like George won the open challenge for the MCW International title. Who's going to answer? Oh, I know that George might have bit off more than he could chew. You don't know what could happen on the Raw after Mania, ladies and gentlemen. It looks like we're going to have a new debuting star in MCW and Darby Allin. But is he really here? I got a doubt that he's really here. We've seen the vignettes on Instagram that he's coming to MCW. And is he really here tonight? Is he going to accept the challenge for George's International Championship? George looking at the Titantron. He's confused. And there's Sting. There is Sting. Sting's coming out here. And there's Darby Allin. There he is. This bout is set for one fall with a 30-minute time limit. It is for the MCW International Championship. Introducing first, accompanied by Sting from Seattle, Washington, weighing in at 170 pounds, the relentless Darby Allin. And it looks like Darby Allin is here tonight. And what a great debut it could be if he could defeat George in his first title defense here tonight and become the 4th ever MCW International Champion. And here comes Darby Allin into the ring. Darby Allin looks focused. This is his first showing here in MCW. The crowd is hyped to see Darby Allin here tonight. I've never expected it, but we've been waiting for quite a while now, because ever since those vignettes, on Instagram were shown, we've been anticipating the debut of Darby Allin. And it looks like he's here, and he's brought Sting with him. And that was on the line at MCW International Championship. But let's waste no more time, and let's get this matchup going.
Ding, ding, ding.
And ladies and gentlemen, the bell has sounded in a slap to the face. The Darby out of the gate, and George mocking Darby. And Darby going to return the favor. Both men slapping each other. George going for a clothesline. Darby ducks, and Darby with a flying forearm. And now Darby with the forearm smash is taking the fight to George early on. George pushing him back in. Oh my god. almost got decapitated by that clothesline, ladies and gentlemen. And Darby, he's already down and out in the early goings of this matchup. And there's a headlock by the Hitman. And it's wrenched in deep. I think Darby might be out already in this one. This is not really a good showing for Darby so far. George with that headlock locked in deep. Now talking trash to... Oh, that's uncalled for. That is uncalled for. Making fun of the legendary Lex Luger to Sting. Sting's close friend. Darby trying his hardest to at least get George's arm from underneath his chin so he can at least get some breathing room. And now Darby fighting out. I think Darby is starting to get back up to his feet. He is on his hands and knees, and now he's up on his knees, ladies and gentlemen. On his knees now, George is up on his feet. And George, and oh my God, George gonna slam Darby down into the mat and now taunting the crowd. And I think he might not want to turn around because Darby is back up behind him. And now shotgun drop kick to the ribs of George. And Darby has just caught George out of surprise and now bounce off the ropes with the tope suicida, taking George down. My man flew like a cannonball, ladies and gentlemen. And now Darby gonna get George back up. He's gonna start taking him into the ring. He cannot win this matchup by count out. He would not win the title that way. And now throwing George back inside the ring, gonna take the action in there. And now the ground grappling by Darby. Darby really does not do grappling like that. He uses his speed and agility in these matches. And now trying to go for a German suplex. No, breaks it up. Looking for a Stun Dog Millionaire. No, George reverses. And now George with a German suplex, dropping Darby on the back of his head. And Darby might be dazed. He might even have a concussion if he landed the right way on his head. And as you see, that George is going to go over to Darby. Yeah, and now talking trash to him in the corner. And was he, oh my God, there's a punch to the face of Darby. And now laying down the shots into the face of Darby and not going to lay the boots in. He's going to stomp Darby down in that turnbuckle corner, ladies and gentlemen. And as you see Sting cheering Darby on, telling him to get back in the game, telling him to get the advantage. And now George is getting him up in the power slam position. What the hell is he doing? And now, is he climbing the ropes? And George is on the second rope with Darby up on his shoulder. And Darby gonna put a stop on whatever he was gonna do. And wait a minute. Stun Dog Millionaire off the second rope by Darby. My goodness, I guess George was trying to go for a power slam off the second rope, but Darby able to reverse it into the Stun Dog. And now crawling in for the pinfall on top of George. One, two, and wait. Oh, George got his foot on the bottom rope, and that's a rope break, ladies and gentlemen. And Darby just now noticing he has to break up the count, ladies and gentlemen. My goodness, that was a crazy Stun Dog Millionaire. Now George gonna roll to the outside of the ring. That might be the best thing for him to do. Trying to catch his breath, and now George resting on them steps. Darby on the apron. What does he have in mind, Darby? Oh, he missed this mark, and he smacked his back right off the steps, ladies and gentlemen. What's going to happen when we come back here on MCW Raw?
Congratulations! You just won an iPhone 13!
Ooh, that brother's floating in the air!
Are you sick of these scammers? Click or call today, 1-800-SICK-OF-THESE-SCAMMERS.
Got this feeling down deep in my soul that I just can't lose. Guess I'm on my way. Need any friend? And I feel now, I guess I'll be with you till the end.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back here on MCW Raw episode 11. And during the break, Darby's back is being again worked on heavily by George. The stomps, and now this, like, Darby getting bent over George's knee. Look at his back. Look at the way his back is bent. But if you didn't see before the break, the reason why George is targeting the back is because Darby tried to go for a con hilo takedown to George into the steps, but he missed George, and he smacked the steps, causing that damage to his back, and George threw him off his knee. and now crawling over to Sting, I guess. I guess Sting has to tell him something. And George, what's George doing? He's not going over to Darby. I think he's going to pick up Darby's skateboard. He won't even be able to use that as a weapon. He's picking up Darby's skateboard now. Why the hell does he need the skateboard?
This
and now what does he have
skateboard.
In mind with that board? And oh my God, slam the skateboard across the back. And if he does that again, that might be a disqualification for George. Darby really is worked till the night, ladies and gentlemen. He is not back up on his feet. And now George on the outside of the ring. What the hell is he doing? And now he has a hold of a steel chair. We see what he's capable of with a steel chair in his debut at Unchained. And now the referee going to get a hold of that chair because this is not a no disqualification match. Darby getting back up to his feet. And now the referee got that chair. But wait a minute, Darby with the skateboard to the injured knee from last week. If you remember that knee, that same knee that Darby just hit. George tried to do a flying leg drop off the top rope onto the apron, but he missed. And now Darby, coffin drop onto the back. And wait a minute, roll up. One, two, three. Ding, ding, ding. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner of this match and still the MCW International Champion, George the Hitman Quick. What a match, ladies and gentlemen. And Darby did put up one hell of a fight against George for his first showing here in MCW. But he was not able to get the job done against George in this matchup and become MCW International Champion. But let's take a look at some of the replays of this matchup. As you see, Darby was going for the Stun Dog Millionaire. But George was able to turn it into a German suplex that sent Darby flying on the back of his head. And then when Darby hit the Stun Dog Millionaire, it was off the second rope. And then Darby went for that Con Hilo takedown, but he smacked the steps, missing George completely. And then here's what ended the match, a coffin drop. But George was able to roll up Darby and win the matchup there. And you gotta wonder, Darby just missed this matchup. He missed the W by the skin of his teeth thanks to George, but George is still the champ.
So Corbin, I just gotta ask you your thoughts about the very handsome Latino heat Kayden collects. Oh shit, hopefully Jefferson is, anyway, can I get your thoughts on him coming down to the ring and costing you the win? And will you make a rebuttal anytime soon?
My thoughts? That bastard collects cost me a match against the Hardcore Champion and you want my thoughts? Okay, well I'll leave you and the rest of the MCW staff with this. You all better have a cleanup crew ready because when I find Kalex, I'm going to beat his ass all over this arena. And as far as my thoughts go, I think you should really just leave me alone. And for you, Kalex, you better watch your back because of the MCW Revolution. I'll make sure you walk out wearing a crimson mask of your own blood. And if I have to break a couple of your bones to do it, so be it. Because you know it just as well as I do. I'll do exactly what I did at Mania, and I'll do it as many times as I need to. I will beat the ever-loving shit out of you. So don't let that ego get too big.
Well, what's some words from Corbin, and he is right, the next pay-per-view MCW Revolution. But besides that, Damian, let's talk about AFWE's actions last week at WrestleMania for a second. He is scheduled to come out here in a few moments to address why and his motive behind attacking Cena, but here's the clip right here. As you see, Cena celebrating and he just gets laid out by AFWE. And then, like, this is the most brutal attack I've seen in MCW so far. And look at this, just puts the chair around Cena's neck and bam, right into the steel post. Right into that steel post goes Cena's neck with that chair around his head. And who knows what the hell was going on in AFWE's head. We're gonna know why. I'm still at a loss of words. That's why I'm stumbling, but we're gonna know why he did what he did last week at Mania. And here comes AFWE, and it sounds like he has a new theme song, ladies and gentlemen. Looks like he's getting a new theme song for this new personality he has. But we're gonna find out why he did what he did last week on WrestleMania, the John Cena. And there he is, he's coming down in the suit. Why is he coming down in the suit? Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome at this time, AFWE! And here comes AFWE making his way down to the ring. You gotta wonder why the hell is he wearing a suit. I guess he wants to get rid of this goody two-shoes image he has made of himself. And he was one of the fan favorites in MCW, but what caused him to snap, why did he do what he did, but we're going to find out his motive behind that here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. As you see, he's making his way down to the ring. He's usually coming out through that tunnel running, but looks like he's not going to show any appreciation to the fans, just walking like a dead zombie, to be honest. You gotta wonder all the frustration AFWE has been going through for the past week. He came back from injury after losing the MCW World Heavyweight Championship just to lose to John Cena in this return matchup at the biggest stage of MCW history, WrestleMania. And AFWE, I guess he let that loss get to his head, putting that chair around Cena's neck and smashing that chair against the steel post. Cena is out with a crushed trachea by the looks of it, and he's going to be out until at least Raw episode 13, which is after Revolution. But let's find out what AFWE has to say about his actions last week on John Cena.
My phone has been absolutely blowing up. Why, AJ? Why would you attack Cena after the match? Because he's a phony. He is overhyped. And you fans? Whew. Where can I begin? Oh, AJ's washed. Oh, AJ's a scrub. You fat-ass keyboard warriors have to wash the grease off of your plates every single night because you eat fast food and sit at your computer all day. Cheetos for you all. And you all are all just phonies. You can't lace up my boots. Anyone in this company cannot lace up my boots because I am the best. I am the first ever MCW champion, and I held that championship, and I held it tight. I don't care. I don't care what people say about me. I don't care about their opinions because you all turned your backs on me, and I'm turning my back on you. I am returning the favor because I don't feel you guys are worthy of getting a nice AJ Atlas because I am disrespected in this company by the fans, by the chairman. Hey, Demarion, how you doing? Well, maybe you should respect me. Everyone in this crowd needs to respect your first ever MCW champion. And I'm going to hold that title on my name forever, and no one is going to stop me. And for Cena, I can't even speak about him. He's going to be gone for almost forever. I almost ended his career. I mean, who even cares about John Cena anymore? The only thing that matters is that you fans, you don't know what you got yourselves into.
Well, what's some words from AFWE? Not really about Cena, about the situation last week, but just went on a whole tirade against the fans and mentioned me in there. I didn't even do anything to him. Anyways, I guess we're truly not going to find out why John Cena was attacked, but it's probably because AFWE is sick and tired of these fans. He wants to take out the fan favorite in that matchup. But to be honest, I kind of convinced that he was a sore loser against John Cena.
After we get back from the commercial break, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be the Demon Jack versus the Lunatic Fringe Jefferson in the main event of the night on Raw episode 11. What's going to happen? Which one of these men are going to win? Find out when we come back.
You boys new around here?
Yeah, I'm AFWE Pop-Tart.
And I'm Orange Crush Pop-Tart.
Well then, two big swigs on me.
She was really cool.
Can't hold your soda, boys.
Crazy good!
BK $5 Your Way Meal is here to make your choice easy and so tasty. Go straight to the Double Whopper Jr. with piping hot small fries, four-piece crispy nuggets, and a refreshing small drink. Can you believe you get all this for only $5? The $5 Your Way Meal, only at Burger King.
YouTube TV is a reinvented way to watch TV. No wires, no boxes, and unlimited DVR.
Wait, unlimited DVR?
Yeah, that's right.
I'm worried what that much power might do to me.
Okay. YouTube TV has real-time highlights to catch up on the game if you miss anything.
I actually like missing things. My team's awful.
Well, it also has personalized recommendations, so no more scrolling endlessly.
But scrolling endlessly lets me reject things.
Yeah, but...
Reject.
All right, that's enough. Look, you should try YouTube TV for free. It's everything live TV should be.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we are back here tonight on MCW Raw Episode 11. And we're getting ready for our main event here tonight. The Lunatic Fringe Jefferson versus the Demon Jack. Both of these men weren't successful inside their matches at WrestleMania, with Jefferson losing the triple threat and Jack losing his MCW International Championship in his first title defense. But let's see if they can bounce back their momentum here tonight after this one. Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is your main event of the evening. It is scheduled for one fall with a 30-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Cincinnati, Ohio, weighing in at 226 pounds, the Lunatic Fringe, Jefferson. Jefferson making his way down to the ring. You can see the determination on his face here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. And Jefferson entering through the crowd. You're going to wonder all the frustration in his head after losing the first ever MCW main event. He came so far, coming back from injury early and winning the MCW Royal Rumble. The first ever MCW Royal Rumble at that. That was staying his name. But just like old times, Ghost comes in and screws with Jefferson. But if either one of these men could win this matchup here tonight, they could bring back their momentum to them. Ladies and gentlemen, the Demon has arrived. And his opponent from Chicago, Illinois, weighing in at 190 pounds, the Demon, Jack! Jack competed in the first ever MCW WrestleMania match in history against George Rich. If you know, if you tuned in early or seen the pay-per-view, he lost the International Championship to George, which was a pretty damn good match. One of the best matches I've seen here in MCW yet. I recommend go check it out if you haven't already. But Jack looking to get the win against Jefferson here tonight to bring back his momentum and bring back his rankings here on the top MCW International Championship card. Well, I mean division, not card. Jack has a very diverse crowd here tonight. Half of the people love him, half of the people hate him. It's just like John Cena, one of the most polarizing superstars in MCW. And Jack making his way into the ring. This is Jack's second MCW Raw match. His first one was on episode 8, I believe, episode 8 or 7, when he faced Damian the Dominator in that non-title match, which was a pretty good match for Jack's first singles match. But let's see if he can hold the same to Jefferson here tonight, because Jefferson is a crazed man and he's looking for vengeance, especially after Damian. I'm pretty sure what he has going on with Damian is not over yet, in my eyes. Here we go. And now to start the match of Colorado tie-up. Who's going to get the upper hand, Jefferson or Jack? And by the looks of things, it looks like it's pretty even. No, looks like Jefferson's going to turn it into a headlock. And if you remember, Jack just recently lost his international championship to George at WrestleMania last week. And Jefferson lost the triple threat at Mania in the main event. So if any one of these guys could win, they could get their momentum back and going to the prizes they want to get. And now it looks like Jack is going to go ahead and bounce Jefferson off the ropes. Jefferson bounce off the ropes and a drop kick by Jack, taking Jefferson down. Jefferson not in the driver's seat anymore. Here's the couple. One, two, and it looks like Jeff is going to overpower Jack into a roll-up of his own. One, two, no. Looks like Jack's going to overpower Jefferson. And now Jefferson double foot stomped to Jefferson by Jack. That drop kick must have done the number one. Two, no, kick out at two by Jefferson, and it looks like he is still in this matchup. He is not giving up anytime soon, and now looks like Jack going to go for the 1916, putting this match away already, but no, and oh my God, that stiff-looking clothesline just knocking Jack out, and now Jefferson is going to look for, he's looking for a bulldog choke possibly, looking for a bulldog choke. He has him in a headlock, but he's squeezing down on the head pretty damn hard, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, that wrench in pretty deep. And wait a minute, Damian's in the ring with a chair. Damian's in the ring, and oh my God, he just hit Jefferson with a chair. Ding, 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 ding. And it looks like Damian calls Jack the match, but he doesn't care about Jack. Jefferson wins by disqualification, but he's out here to destroy Jefferson. And oh my God, ramming the edge of that chair into the spine of Jefferson. He's going to injure this man if he keeps doing that, ladies and gentlemen. And I think that's his goal. And it looks like Jefferson gonna roll over That must have done a lot of impact on the spine of Jefferson. And it looks like Damian ain't done. And I'm going to ram that chair, the top of that chair, into the ribs of Jefferson. He's going to break and crack his ribs all over the place, ladies and gentlemen. Good Lord. Just smashing that chair like 10, 11 times into the ribs of Jefferson. And Jefferson, that could be some internal injuries bound to happen from that attack just there, ladies and gentlemen. Well, Damian, I guess he was set out for his goal to end the career of Jefferson, and it looks like he has done so here tonight. Jefferson could be seriously hurt.
Are you tired of being old? Well, if you are, we have the perfect solution. DEW's cream. Make sure you squeeze it out nice and good. Two squirts and rub that trap in. And one day later, you should be nice and young. Look at that. Didn't that work perfect, man?
If you have a history of heart problems, do not use this cream. It may cause death. Call 999-999-999.
Welcome back to MCW Raw Episode 11. What an explosive night has been, but time to end it off with the new MCW World Heavyweight Champion, Kayden. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your new MCW World Heavyweight Champion, Kayden. And here comes the man that was able to overcome the odds of Jefferson and Damian in the same match to become this third ever MCW World Heavyweight Champion, the Ghost One now, Kayden. And as you see Kayden making his way down to the ring, the first time he has been MCW World Heavyweight Champion, and the first time we've seen a new person besides Damian hold the title in like a long time. The last time we've seen someone hold a title other than Damian was AFWE back at Judgment Day. So that says a lot. Almost a year of Damian holding the MCW World Heavyweight Championship. But that title reign came to an end last Sunday when Kayden was able to do what he was set out to do, and that was pin Jefferson in the middle of the ring and win the MCW World Heavyweight Championship, which he did. You gotta wonder how much hard work Kayden put inside his MCW career. And there you see, the confetti is gonna start falling. I know that's gonna be a pain for the ring crew to clean up after the show ends. But as you see confetti falling, and it looks like Ghost is gonna have a celebration for his MCW World Heavyweight Championship reign. Well, the beginning of it and his victory, not reign. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, if you didn't know, the next MCW pay-per-view is MCW Revolution. Will Ghost have anything to say about that? And will he mention anything about his upcoming title match there?
When I was last in this ring, I said that I would pin Jefferson's ass in the middle of that ring and become the world champion. And I'm a man of my word, because that's exactly what I did. Now, I could come out here and I could say 1,000 different things about Jefferson or Damian, but I want to talk about you guys, the fans, just for a second. You guys are what got me here. And I think that I should seriously just take one second and appreciate every single one of you. Seriously, thank you all so much, because whether you booed me or you cheered me, I was in this ring and you guys were supporting me the entire way. And I can't thank you guys enough. And I think of myself as a lot of different things, but one of them is a liar. I didn't need anyone to get me here. None of you. I worked my ass off to get where I am, and none of you supported me. And now I'm gonna run this show, and I'm gonna run it how I want. You can call me whatever you want, but just make sure it has champion in front of it.
And what the hell? That's George. That's George's music. Why is the MCW International Champion George coming out here? He's coming out here with the original MCW International Championship title belt as well. But he threw that in a trash can all the other night. He has his new version and then that's the original version. What the hell is that all about? But why is he out here and why has he got a microphone? What does he have to say to Kayden? George is a master at many things, and one of those things is trash talking his opponents and people around him.
Kayden, you must be wondering, why am I out here? And that's very simple. To congratulate you. I hate to see all these people underestimating you. All these people taking you for granted. And you proved them all wrong. And when you pinned that little piece of shit, Jefferson, in the middle of that ring to become MCW World Heavyweight Champion. Oh, I almost forgot. This is a gift box. It has a gift for you, my friend. And I really do hope you enjoy it.
And it looks like George is going to give Kayden the old International Championship a belt he has once held. George giving that MCW International Championship to Kayden as a gift. And now why the hell is Damian coming out here? Damian also has a microphone, but he looks pissed. But we just seen Damian not too long ago, before the commercial break, attacking Jefferson in the middle of his match. The match was even 2 minutes in, and he cost Jack the disqualification for Jefferson to win. But what the hell does Damian have to say to Ghost?
Alright, listen here, Ghost. I'm just gonna cut straight to the chase. You did not pin me at WrestleMania. So therefore, I get rematch clause. I am the greatest MCW World Heavyweight Champion to step foot in this company. And I'm getting my rematch. Whether it's now or at the pay-per-view.
Oh boy, things have escalated real quickly, ladies and gentlemen. And, oh, wait a minute. What the hell? Jefferson's music is playing. And there's Jefferson, taped up ribs and all, with a damn barbed wire baseball bat. Why is he coming out here? He's probably ready to seek some vengeance. And the Damian, and oh my god. No, he's out to kill. He just took out George for no reason. And now Ghost gonna push Damian into Jefferson's barbed wire bat shot. And Kayden gonna run out of here. Kayden getting the hell out of there. Running like he's seen the damn Ghost, no pun intended. And now gonna go over to Nurse George. I guess he's gonna accept George as his running buddy. As you see Jefferson saying this close, almost bashed your head in with the baseball bat. And Jefferson, it looks like he wants another title shot at what's rightfully his in his mind, ladies and gentlemen. What an explosive week we've always had, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you next week on Raw.